contents of the 16th May 2020 issue of the Economic and Political Weekly. I'm Lina Mathias, Executive Editor. I will begin as I usually do with editorials. The first editorial is titled Living with COVID-19. It says that one repeatedly hears voices both from the governments and other agencies like the World Health Organization that say that we will have to accept the inevitability of living with the coronavirus. It goes on to decode the real meaning of this expression in the context of promises made, the limitations that have been exposed, and ultimately center-state relations. The second editorial is titled, Who Loves a Labor Law Ordinance? State governments' labor law ordinances tend to barter labor rights for business interests, says this editorial, and goes on to say that with these ordinances, contrary to the constitutional presumptions of free labor, the state is creating a reserve of distress-driven labor force. Our editor, Professor Gopal Guru's column from the editor's desk this time is titled, Journalism in the Normative Mode. It looks at the similarity of location and the normative difference in the roles performed by the police and media persons on the front lines of fighting COVID-19. He examines both the police and media persons empirically sharing the same risky space, and then goes on to draw insights, especially on the from the role of the media particularly, in how they share this space, what are their respective roles. The H.T. Parekh column this time is titled Outsourcing the Stimulus. My colleague, senior assistant editor Sunipa Dasgupta, in her, when she speaks to you in Economics with EPW, will speak further on this column. In the commentary section, we have Walls That Speak. This looks at online education. The lockdown period has seen a terrific increase in this kind of education. And what it says, an interesting aspect, it says it needs to be discussed how social disparities and embarrassments are made visible by video conferencing, and how this displaces a large section of students from access to and equity in education. Another commentary, Remaking the Indian Military for Women. This examines the Babita Punia judgment and goes on to say how the judgment in this case illustrates the gender stereotypes, inequality and discrimination deeply embedded in the Indian military, discusses this aspect. The next commentary, Density, Distancing, Informal Settlements and the Pandemic. The fifth commentary, Significance of Testing for Identification of COVID-19. Now this is a state level analysis. The authors have based their analysis on data from 8 states, and they say that identification, this data shows them that identification and quarantine of those who are infected slows down the spread of the disease. Now we come to this week's special. Review of Women's Studies. This is a review that has had a long history in the EPW. It's also one of the most read reviews in the journal. This time the theme is Gender, Labor and the Constitution. the introduction, and I quote, the introduction to the collection of six articles says, "The emergence of women workers as a dynamic force in several forms of worker struggles is a remarkable feature of the Indian landscape, but is unfortunately left out of the frame sometimes." So then, in this collection, there are six articles which examine women's unpaid labor, subsidizing the wage economy, land dispossession leading to the adverse social inclusion, gender implications in anti-reservation judgments, working of local committees that address sexual harassment at the workplace, the Maternity Benefit Act and its amendments, and implications of the labor codes and anti-trafficking interventions on female labor migration. Now, the guest editors of this review, this edition of the review, are Indrani Mazumdar and Soumya Umma, and the members of the editorial advisory group, Ritu Diwan, V. Geeta, Ghazala Jamil, Prabha Kotiswaran, Gurpreet Mahajan, Kavita Punjabi, and Meera Velayudhan. EPW has thanked them. I thank them for putting this issue together on gender, labor, and the constitution. They worked through the lockdown period to bring us this collection. And I also thank our senior assistant editor, Lubna Dugal, for coordinating this issue from the EPW side. So as you see, lots to read in this issue. Please do look it up. Thank you.